हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल। सो टुडे वी विल टेक ईन रिएक्शन एंड इट्स इम्पॉर्टेंट प्रॉपर्टीज, वेरियस एग्जांपल्स। दिस रिएक्शन इज़ वेरी वेरी इम्पॉर्टेंट। सो व्हाट इज ईन रिएक्शन? ईन रिएक्शन इज़ बिटवीन ईन एंड इनोफाइल। इट इज़ वेरी मच सिमिलर टू डील्स एंड रिएक्शन वेयर वी हैव डाईन एंड डाइनोफाइल। सिमिलरली हेयर वी हैव ईन एंड इनोफाइल। ईन इज़ अ स्पीशीज विच इज़ इलेक्ट्रॉन रिच इन नेचर and enophile is electron deficient, so it always wants electrons, and if we attach a group which is electron withdrawing in nature, it will increase the reactivity of this reaction. Similarly, if we attach a group which is electron rich in nature, will increase the efficiency of ene, right? In this way it will increase the rate of the reaction. So this species, we have allylic hydrogen here, right? So we should have a alkene having allylic hydrogen atom, alkene with allylic hydrogen atom, and a alkene which can be attached with different type of functional groups, right? So this alkene with allylic hydrogen atom is called as ene, and this alkene which is generally attached with a electron withdrawing group is called enophile. So this reaction involves transfer of this proton from this allylic position to this carbon, and then this pi bond will shift here to form a new sigma bond. This pi bond will shift here to form a new pi bond, right? So in this way there is formation of new sigma bond and breakage of this sigma bond. So this reaction requires a very high temperature, means heat is required for the reaction. If heat is not given in the reaction, there must be a Lewis acid which will increase the rate of reaction at room temperature or at moderate temperatures. So after shifting of bonds, what type of molecule you will get? We will get this proton attached with this carbon, and this bond is new sigma bond, and we have a new point pi bond here, like this type of molecule we will get. This is the basic reaction. This is, you can say, another basic example. Here we have a allylic hydrogen, alkene with the allylic hydrogen, and this alkene is acting as a enophile. So this proton will shift on this carbon, this will shift here to form a new sigma bond, this will shift here to form a new pi bond, right? So this proton will attach with this carbon. This is a basic example. Suppose we have this type of alkene. Here we have three methyl groups, and all of them can act as a allylic hydrogen. All of them can provide allylic hydrogen. In this way we have total 9 hydrogens which can act as allyl, which can participate in the transfer. But we know we need only one. So how we can decide that which one will participate first? In the starting of video I have told you that ene is acting as a electron rich moiety, means it is providing electrons to the enophile. So if our ene is becoming more electron rich in nature, then it will become more active, means the protons which are attached with more electron rich carbon will act as a more reactive in nature. So these two methyl are close to each other, and it's providing high electron density to this carbon, right? So this carbon is electron rich in nature. You can write down it like this. These two methyls having hydrogens are more reactive in nature as compared to this one. So you have to find out that which allylic hydrogen will be more electron rich. So it will be transferred. Now question comes that it will transfer to this carbon or this one, right? We can rotate this enophile by 180 degree, and so we get a new species. So the attachment side will be different. So how we can decide that this proton will be transferred to this carbon or this one? So as we are seeing that which carbon is more electron rich in case of ene, same thing will be happen with enophile, that we have to find out which carbon will be more electron deficient. So this carbon is attached with electron withdrawing group, so it is more electron deficient in nature. So proton will be transferred to this carbon, or you can consider it like this, that this double bond is shifting electron density towards it. दिस कार्बन इज शिफ्टिंग इलेक्ट्रॉन डेंसिटी ऑफ दिस पाई बॉन्ड टूवर्ड्स इट ड्यू टू द क्लोजनेस ऑफ दिस इलेक्ट्रॉन विथड्रॉइंग नेचर, राइट? सो वी हैव ग्रेटर नेगेटिव चार्ज हेयर, सो प्रोटॉन इज कमिंग विद एच प्लस फॉर्म, इज कमिंग इन एच प्लस फॉर्म विद विदाउट इलेक्ट्रॉन, इट हैज़ पॉजिटिव चार्ज, सो इट विल कम्बाइन विद द कार्बन विच इज मोर इलेक्ट्रो विच हैज़ मोर नेगेटिव चार्ज, सो इट विल कम्बाइन विद दिस, दिस बॉन्ड विल शिफ्ट हेयर and this one will shift, so you will get final this type of molecule, right? Then next example we are taking here a triple bond. So triple bond can also act as enophile. So we will take different type of example: carbon double bond carbon, carbon triple bond carbon, carbon double bond O, and carbon double bond N. All these can act as enophile. So first step is the transfer of this proton. So this proton will be transferred to this carbon, right? We can transfer to any of these two because both are attached with same type of functional group. Then next step is the shifting of this bond. It will shift here. We will get a proton attached here and two CO2-Me group will go on the same side. So what is the outcome of this reaction? Means here we are doing two things. We are breaking carbon hydrogen bond, this carbon hydrogen bond is breaking, and here we are forming a new carbon carbon bond, right? We are doing two steps here, or you can consider it equivalent to formation of new carbon hydrogen bond. New carbon hydrogen bond is forming with this carbon, right? There are two steps are taking place here, so these two things are will be done on the same side. As we know that all the pericyclic reaction or most of the pericyclic reactions are concerted in nature. Concerted means they will go in single step. So the attachment, the side of attachment of carbon, new carbon hydrogen bond and new carbon carbon bond will be same. Means these two bond will go on the same side. So these two will automatically will become same in nature. Right. So we can call this feature as cis addition of bonds. Then we will take reaction with heteroenophile. Heteroenophile means we are taking here we are taking carbon double bond carbon, or we are taking carbon triple bond carbon, but we can have carbon double bond O, or we can have carbon double bond N. Means we can have different type of atoms attached here, so it can also act as enophile. So same thing will happen. First we have to find out that which is our ene and which is enophile. So this is our ene having allylic hydrogen, and this one will act as a enophile. Here we are not using high temperature condition, here we are using Lewis acid. So Lewis acid is basically attaching with this oxygen, making it more electron deficient. More electron deficient means it will become more reactive in nature, so we need low temperature conditions. So easily this proton will be transferred to this oxygen, this carbon will shift here to this bond, will shift here to form a new bond, this bond will shift here to form a new pi bond. So we get this type of final molecule. So next we have another example of this heteroenophile. Here we have carbon double bond nitrogen and it is attached with this tosyl group. Again we are using a Lewis acid here. So first step is the identification of allylic hydrogen we have here. So it will act as ene and it will act as enophile. So this proton will be transferred to this nitrogen, this bond will shift here to form a new bond, and this will shift here to form a new pi bond. We will get this one as final product. Then we have a very interesting example here. This is an example of intramolecular ene reaction. So in the starting I have told you that there is cis addition of new carbon hydrogen bond and carbon carbon bond, right? So this thing will also be applied in case of intramolecular ene reaction, and it is almost 100% true for the formation of 5-membered ring, right? If you are forming 6-membered ring, then sometimes you have to look at the chair conformation of the cyclohexane, and then you can decide that which side will be the attachment side. But in case of 5-membered ring, this rule is ऑलमोस्ट 100% ट्रू दैट देयर इज अटैचमेंट, देयर इज दिस एडिशन ऑफ कार्बन हाइड्रोजन एंड कार्बन कार्बन बॉन्ड. सो फर्स्ट स्टेप इज वी विल फाइंड आउट दैट विच विल एक्ट एज आर एलाइलिक हाइड्रोजन. This is double bond and it is attached with these two allylic carbon. So any of these two provide proton. This is our ene. So first step is the transfer of this proton, and it will be transferred to the carbon which is more electron, which has more negative charge. After shifting of this pi bond, it will has greater negative charge because it is close to this electron withdrawing group. So this pi electron cloud will be shifted to this carbon, right? So this hydrogen having positive charge will attack on this carbon. This will shift here to form a new sigma bond, and this will shift here to form a new pi bond, right? So this will be the molecule. Next question comes that after the formation of five-membered ring, there is attachment site that there is cis addition of carbon hydrogen and carbon carbon bond. So these two groups will go on the same side. Why they are going on the same side? Because when we are forming a carbon hydrogen bond here on this carbon and new carbon carbon bond this side, these two things are on the same side. So other side left will be available for these two groups. So they will go on the same side. Right, so this will be our final molecule. Next example is very good to understand the stereochemistry of Ene's reaction. Right, so first thing is that we will try to find out that what is our Ene and which will act as enophile. So this hydrogen is allylic hydrogen. So this part will act as Ene and this will act as enophile. Then we will try to find out different type of protons attached here. We have one proton attached on this carbon. It will participate in, it will help us to identify its stereochemistry. So we will identify it first. Suppose it is H dash, and on this carbon we have suppose H double dash, right? So what is the mechanism? This proton will be transferred here. This will shift here and this will shift here to form a new sigma bond. So we can understand it in this molecule, this ene will be delivered to the bottom side of this enophile, right? It will be delivered from the bottom side. So if we will look at the Newman projection of it, then we will see this carbon first and this carbon will go on the back side. So suppose this is our front carbon, this one, and this will go on the back side, which is denoted by this outer circle. So we have two carbons here, rest are left, these three, they will go like this, right? So this is not five membered ring, this is total six membered ring, but this is our back carbon. We are looking it like a Newman projection. So this carbon, this hydrogen which is denoted by H dash, will go on the back side because this ene is attacking from the bottom side. Why it is attacking from the bottom side? Because its tether is small. This is small in size, so it cannot attack from the upper face. It is attacking from the lower face, right? So in this way, this H prime or H dash will go on the back side. This is back side, right? And this H double dash, which is attached with this carbon, will come on the front side because this carbon is on the top and this one on the bottom side. It will go like this. So that is why I have denoted these two by different names. So you can recognize that this one is coming out of the plane, this one is going inside the plane, right? And this ene is also on the bottom side. It is connected with this carbon. So we will attach it like this, right? We can denote it by this. And this oxygen will be attacked by this Lewis acid. So it will become more electropositive in nature. So reaction will become faster. So in the final molecule, this proton which is going inside the plane will be denoted by like this, right? We can write down it like H dash. And this alkene will come on the upper side of this carbon. And this proton which is coming out of the plane connected with this carbon will come above the plane. right? This will be the final molecule. So as I've told you earlier, that in case of six member ring or larger ring, it is not easy to determine the stereochemistry of Ene's reaction, so you have to be careful about them. Then next is the next reaction we are taking here, Ene, which is connected with two allylic carbons, right? So any one of them can participate in the reaction. The reaction is very simple, but there is one thing which I have want to tell you about this, that is why I have taken it here. So I will write it down like this, right? So this will be our enophile, and it will become activated after attachment of Lewis acid. So this proton will be transferred to this oxygen. This bond will shift here to form a new sigma bond, and this will shift here to form new pi bond. So we will have product like this. Right, now the question comes that what will be the attachment site of this methyl and this OH. So they can be syn to each other or anti. Means we can have two type of products here. This is syn addition and this one is anti addition product. Right, so how you will decide that which will be your final product? So this reaction involves a six member transition state, right? So we will try to draw that six member transition state in form of chair structure. Why it is six form? That we have taken this type of structure in the starting. So it involves a transition state in which there is new sigma bond formation between these two carbons and between carbon and hydrogen. So and there is new pi bond formation here. Right, this type of transition state is involved. So this is a six member transition state. So we can write down this state in chair form, right? So first we will write down our enophile, and suppose this CO2Me is going in equatorial direction first. This is a stable structure. This type of transition state is involved, right? So this methyl is occupying this side because these two bonds are cis to each other. Right, that is why I have drawn it like this. Then there is, after shifting of bond, this proton will be transferred here, this will transfer here, this will transfer here, right? So this, there is formation of OH bond here and Me here. Me is located here, right? So this OH and this Me are axial equatorial to each other at 1-2 position. At 1-2 carbon, they are axial equatorial to each other, so they will be syn in nature, right? So this is the transition state for this molecule. And if we are drawing an unstable structure in which this CO2Me will occupy axial direction, it will remain as such, right? This type of structure will form. So same reaction will take place. This proton will be transferred here, this bond will shift here, this will shift here. Now this OH and Me are again syn to each other. But if you look at this hydrogen, so structure, what type of structure you will get here? You will get this type of structure. And when you will rotate this carbon to get this CO2Me group in place of this proton, you will get this anti structure, right? So because of the axial location of this CO2Me group, this transition state is comparatively less stable than this one. That is why we will get syn product in this case. Then next is metal ene reaction. So in ene reaction we have seen that there is transfer of allylic proton, but in place of allylic proton we can have metals at allylic position. So same type of reaction will take place. First we have to identify which is our ene and which is our enophile. So this is ene, metal ene, and this is enophile, right? So this MgCl will transfer here, this bond will shift here, and this will shift here. So the attachment site will be same to this carbon, newly formed carbon, this carbon, and this carbon metal bond will be on same side. It is similar to the cis addition, right? So we will get this product. Then we are using this water, so OH will be removed and H will attach here. We will get this one as final molecule. नेक्स्ट इज अगेन सेम मेटलिन रिएक्शन, बट दिस टाइम इट इज इंट्रामोलिकुलर इन नेचर. सो इट इज ऑल्सो वेरी सिंपल दैट वी हैव हेयर, दिस इज आर इन मेटलिन एंड दिस विल एक्ट एज इनोफाइल. सो दिस बॉन्ड विल शिफ्ट हेयर, दिस विल शिफ्ट हेयर, दिस विल शिफ्ट हेयर. सो वी विल गेट हेयर अ न्यूली फॉर्म फाइव मेंबर रिंग. दिस एम जी सी एल विल अटैच विद दिस कार्बन. वी विल हैव अ सिग्मा बॉन्ड हेयर एंड अ न्यू पाई बॉन्ड हेयर. देन वी आर यूजिंग दिस एल डी हाई, राइट? सो दिस कार्बन हैविंग नेगेटिव चार्ज, दिस मैग्नीशियम हैज पॉजिटिव चार्ज, सो दिस कार्बन हैज नेगेटिव चार्ज. इट विल अटैक ऑन दिस कार्बन, दिस बॉन्ड विल शिफ्ट हेयर. वी विल गेट ओ एच फॉर्मेशन हेयर, राइट? ओ एच विल फॉर्म हेयर एंड दिस बॉन्ड विल रिमेन एज सच एंड दिस विल लीड टू फॉर्मेशन ऑफ 1-2 सिस प्रोडक्ट. देन वी विल टेक, इट इज़ वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग एज वेल एज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एग्जाम्पल. दिस इज ऑल, दिस क्वेश्चन इज ऑल्सो फ्रॉम गेट 2018 और 19 आई थिंक, एंड इट इज़ वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एग्जाम्पल. सो हेयर वी आर यूजिंग फर्स्ट जिंक ब्रोमाइड. सो दिस जिंक ब्रोमाइड विल कंबाइन विद दिस ऑक्सीजन एंड इट विल फॉर्म, दिस विल अटैच लाइक दिस, राइट? आई हैव सिंपली रोटेटेड दिस कार्बन टू फॉर्म अ रिंग लाइक दिस. देन वी कैन फाइंड आउट दैट वेदर इट विल एक्ट एज अ इन रिएक्शन और नॉट. सो दिस जेड एन बी आर टू इज मेकिंग दिस ऑक्सीजन मोर इलेक्ट्रॉन डेफिशिएंट इन नेचर. सो द रिएक्शन विल बिकम फास्टर. वी हैव प्रोटॉन एट एलाइलिक पोजिशन. सो दिस विल सिंपली शिफ्ट टू दिस ऑक्सीजन और वी कैन डिनोट इट बाई डिफरेंट कलर. दिस प्रोटॉन इज ट्रांसफरिंग टू दिस ऑक्सीजन. दिस बॉन्ड विल शिफ्ट हेयर टू फॉर्म अ न्यू कार्बन कार्बन बॉन्ड एंड दिस विल शिफ्ट हेयर टू फॉर्म कार्बन डबल बॉन्ड कार्बन बॉन्ड, राइट? पाई बॉन्ड विल फॉर्म हेयर. सो आंसर इज वेरी सिंपल, वी कैन ईजिली फाइंड इट आउट. बट वॉट अबाउट द स्टीरियो केमिस्ट्री? सो वी विल गेट हेयर OH. After removal of this ZnBr2, we will get OH here, and here we have new pi bond. But what will be the attachment site of these two carbon bond, this carbon and this carbon carbon bond and this carbon oxygen bond? So we will try to find out its transition state. So first we will draw a chair structure for this six membered ring, suppose like this. So I will number these carbons, so it will be more easier to find out. Suppose this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So same thing will be done with this. This is suppose 1, 4, 5, and 6. And we have newly formed bond between 1 and 6. So we will denote them by dashed lines. Right? In transition state, there is formation of bond. So they will be denoted by dashed lines. And this carbon oxygen bond will go equatorial in direction to make this structure stable. Right? So whenever the stereochemistry is not given in the starting and you have a bulkier group, try to locate it in the equatorial direction in transition state, and then you can easily find out the product stereochemistry. So it will go like this. Then we have this carbon carbon double bond on 6th carbon, so it will go like this in equatorial direction. So we will again denote it by dashed lines because this bond is breaking, right? And then we have a bond between this carbon and this carbon, which will be denoted like this. And this bond is breaking, this carbon hydrogen bond is breaking, so we will denote it by dashed lines. Then new bond is forming between this hydrogen and this oxygen, so it will also be denoted by this dashed lines. We have one methyl group attached on this carbon, so we will place it like this, right? So this is our transition state. This methyl will also go in equatorial direction. This is the stable transition state. Then we will try to find out that what type of bond shifting here. So this bond, this proton is shifted to this oxygen. We will denote it by again different color. So this proton is shifted to this oxygen. We have here a double bond which will break. So it will shift here to form new carbon-carbon bond. This bond will shift here to form a new carbon double bond carbon bond like this, right? So in final product we have this type of structure here. So at 1-2 position, at 1-2 position, these two group are equatorial, right? So they should be anti to each other at 1 two position, equatorial, equatorial means they should be empty to each other. And this carbon and this OH are having 1-3 relationship. 1-3 relationship, equatorial, equatorial means they will be cis to each other, right? So if this methyl group is going above the plane, this OH will also go above the plane because they have cis relationship between each other. And this this group will go empty to this OH because they have empty relationship, so we will denote them by dashed lines. So this will be the final stereochemistry of the product, and this reaction is very, very important. Then we will take another example. So why I have taken it here, because it looks very simple, but if you can see that this will act as enophile, it is easy to recognize now. And what about the ene? We have here two pi bonds. This carbon can also provide allylic proton, this can also provide allylic proton, this is denoted like this, so it is also allylic proton. So which proton will participate in the reaction? So always remember, this double bond which is inside the ring is hindered in nature, while this one is free to react. So whenever you have this type of example or this type of question, always prefer this proton which is not in the ring, right, outside the ring, so it will participate in the reaction, these two will not. Then next and the last example is, this is different type of intramolecular ene reaction. We will call it Kohnia ene reaction. So how you will identify it? This is the reaction between ene and enol. So first we are using here LDA. So this LDA will remove this proton which is quite acidic in nature. It is close to the CO2Me group as well as this nitrogen. So it is highly acidic. It can easily be removed. So we will get negative charge here. This will shift here and this bond will shift here to make this oxygen negatively charged, right, which can easily combine with this ZnBr2. So we will have a structure like this and we will get double bond here. So we will denote this molecule in chair form, right? So first and very simple thing is, we will number all the carbons, right? So they will form a 6-membered ring here. This is our first carbon, this is second, third, fourth and fifth, and at fifth nitrogen is connected with this group, so it will go in equatorial direction. Then this sixth carbon is attached with this group, so it will also go in equatorial direction to provide it stability. And on this carbon we have ZnBr2, and here we have OME group, right? We have this type of structure, right? There is no high temperature conditions are given here because we are using Lewis acid, so high temperature conditions are not required in this reaction, so we can easily do it at room temperature. So don't be confused with this. If you have Lewis acid and not high temperature conditions are mentioned, then you can also do ene reaction, right? So first we will find out that what is next, that this ZnBr2 will undergo acidic hydrolysis, right? So it will form OH first, then this proton will be transferred to this carbon-carbon double bond. This bond will shift here to form a new carbon-carbon bond. This will shift here to form a carbon double bond oxygen, right? So what type of structure you will get here? We will get this type of structure, and both of these bonds are moving in the same direction, right? Both bonds are moving in the same direction. So in final product we will get cis type of product here. This will be the final product. So that's it. I will finish this video here. I have covered almost all important part of ene reaction. In next video I will try to finish all the important points of sigmatropic reactions. So keep watching, and if you like my videos, please share my videos with your friends. Thank you so much for watching.